Welcome back. Doing the first of our preparations. As you can see, Kira's doing the trailer. We just parked it up at Herbie Bay Storage, Caravan Storage or something like that. I'm not sure. But yeah, gonna go quickly grab some breakfast.
Just quickly, if you ever are going to Fraser and you need a stall, your camper or your caravan or something, definitely look at Caravan Storage, Herbie Bay or Herbie Bay Caravan Storage. $10 a night. But you can't go wrong.
Lovely. So,
amazing.
Yeah.
It's not covered, but there is an option to have an undercover one. But
I mean, there's quite a few expensive caravans here and boats and whatnot. So you have no stress about having things getting stolen or looked at or anything like that.
I mean, and it's a code access, so you need a code to get in and out. So
yeah, so yeah, and it's far out of town, so there's not really any stress about someone coming.
Far out, but yeah.
It's far enough.
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah, we're gonna drop the hitch, say goodbye to it for a week. She will be missed. And then I'm gonna go get breakfast, and then we're gonna go find the barge. Hopefully, we're not gonna be too late. Go. Hey, hey, hey.
What are we doing?
Dropping the tires.
It's great. Well, we're already on Fraser Island, but it's Fraser time. We are on the island. Quickly dropped our tires down, had a chat to the people at the visitor's store, or the general store, and we are on the road, on the sand.
On the sand road.
On the sand road, so I'll just do it. Crazy to think that we're on the world's largest sand island right now, and it's like the Yeah, when you think of sand island, we're just talking about this. When you think of sand island, you think of sand, not thick debris of trees and everything around. So it's a bit crazy, but I hope you're ready for this journey. I'm still looking out for dingoes. We haven't seen any yet, so.
But yeah.
Let's get it.
All right, here we are back again. We are currently on Fraser Island, as you know, at Wathumba Creek. I don't know how to pronounce it. Anyway,
we have spotted one dingo so far, so I'm happy.
So we're on the right track. And yeah, we'll let the shots speak for themselves when we swing around.
And he's gone. We'll be right back.
back again. First night shot almost. Day two. Not much else to say. Thumba Creek, had a little fish down the at Waddy Point. Unfortunately, we didn't catch anything, but we are enjoying a nice little fire to the thankful people that were here before us. Other than that, bring on tomorrow. See what happens. Alright, here we are, back again. The time is 5:20 in the morning. We are out here on Waddy Point, Orchid Beach. Hopefully let's get some Taylor. We're not the first ones here. There we go. Let's get stuck into it. It's nice and early. We brought breakfast with us. You see, the Nutri-Grain. Kira's not talking because he's probably very tired. So, let's go.
First ever dart. There you go. Good job, bub.
Thanks. A dart for Kira.
Mine was bigger.
Yours is definitely bigger at the moment. That's going to change.
Yeah, right, mate.
My fish.
Whatever.
My fish.
No, we're gonna. That is mine. That is Tom's. I mean, you're close. Oh, so very close. I won today's.
There.
Good job, bub.
Oh, done.
What did you find?
Crab.
So we have just had lunch and we are now prepping our fish for dinner.
Surf and turf tonight.
Yeah, so fresh fish, can't complain. So how are you cooking this, Tom?
Winging it. We got some oranges which we're gonna eat in a different style, but that's alright. But we're gonna try slice them up. Use a bit of garlic butter, salt and pepper, whack it all in. We've got a fire pit that we didn't realize that we had here. And we're just gonna wrap it up in alfoil, put it on there, cook it for a few minutes, and it'll be good to go, I'd say.
Whoop, whoop. Let's go.
Alright, here we are back again. We are currently wrapped up our camp for the day at the Waddy Point campground. And now we're off to Champagne Pools. Apparently it's pretty nice, don't know. It's one of Kira's spots she wants to go to. I can see it right now. So I guess it's because there's lots of waves and makes it foamy, so it makes it look champagne-y, I guess. So let's go and find out. Here we are, back again. All right, we finished up at the Waddy Point campsite. I'll give you a swing around. That's where we were. And there's no camp there now because we all packed up. It's all up there. Have a look at Waddy Camp if you're coming here.
Definitely, yeah.
Because it's one of two or three which are dingo proof. So you have no worries about accidentally leaving any food out or anything like that. So
it's only $14 a night as well.
Yeah.
Do remember though, you need $2 coins for the shower.
Yeah, for hot water.
For hot water, yeah.
You can have cold water showers, but you can't have hot water showers. Comes with their own fire pit, some of them. Not powered, obviously, so self-sufficient, but there is toilets. and amenities. But other than that, yeah. So anyway, we got an early start, so we're... There's someone arguing over there. we're going down to Mahino, and we're going to go to Eli. And other than that, yeah.
Hopefully the sun stays out so we can get some
It's been pleasant.
Going on.
It's been pleasant so far. So yeah. And Kira bought a donut from Kmart last before we came, so we can do she can cruise down Eli.
You know I did.
So yeah. Anyway. Let's get it. So yeah. Waddy Point campsite. Come check it out. Alright, here we are back again. Kira's right there. We have just arrived at the Mahino wreck. Unfortunately, because we didn't leave late, but we left, you can almost say on time, we've arrived at the wrong time to come check out this place. There's a tour bus here. A tour group, sorry.
They should be leaving soon.
Well, yeah, granted, they should be leaving soon. But, yeah, there's quite a few people here. So if you want the shots of YouTube and everything else, get here early. It pays to get here early. But anyway, we're gonna hopefully wait for the tour bus to leave, which should be soon, and then we should get some drop shots. And another tour bus just showed up. Let's hope we can get the timing right. Anyway, we'll kick back soon. So yeah, we're just about to get the drone up and wait for this rain front to pass us with a little bit of spitting. Quick history, it was a steam liner. And it was on under tow because it was going to Japan for £15,000 to use for scrap. Unfortunately, as it was there, it lost tow and washed ashore here. Due to being unable to be refloated, they said, bugger it, let's leave it there. And then ever since then, it's become target practiced. What else it become? It became a, now, well, target practice and tourist destination. That's the two main things. It lived a good life. Like, it was during the Great War, it serviced. During World War II, it was serviced. It was used as target practice, ironically. But other than that, it's lived a good life. Like, it did, I think I saw someone say it did 5 trips to Anzac Cove in Turkey. So it's done well. And for it now to still be glorified as a tourist destination, nearly 200 years old, pretty much now, it's done pretty well, probably more 100. Anyway, we're gonna wait for this rain front to pass and we're gonna get the drone up. Let's go. Again, as you can clearly see, Kira's got her donut out. That means we are at Eli Creek. Once again, same as Mahino, pays to get here early. We'll get some shots and we'll explain why. So, if you want the shots for Instagram, if you want the shots for YouTube, if you want the shots for TikTok,
anything,
for any sort of social media platform, and you don't want anybody around, get here as early as time allows it. Or you willing, or even willing to get here, because it pays to have no one around, and it, yeah. Anyway, this is why I'm being distracted right now, because Kira's exquisitely excited because she's about to drift down the creek of Eli. So yeah. Anyway, we'll kick back soon. Freeway at night. It's cold.
Stop being a princess. Just get in the water, you princess. Bye.
What you doing?
Just let myself down.
You do that.
Back again. So we just did a quick walk down to the lookout for Lake Waddy, depending on who you talk to, depending on how you say it. It's just a watering hole on the back of a sand dune, and you can walk down an extra kilometer down to it. We're not going to do it because we're hungry, pretty much. Well, someone is.
We're both hungry, thank you.
So yeah, if you want to come check it out, it's actually pretty cool. It's like I'll swing it around in a second. It's a sand dune, and literally at the base of it is a watering hole. And apparently there's fish in it. Don't know. Not going to look because we're too far away. But anyway, yeah, it looks cool. Come check it out. Your camera's right there, buddy. Yeah. Alright, here we are, back again. We have shifted camp spots, so we're at Central Station now. So we'll get a little shot of that later. But we've climbed out just quickly for a quick view at Lake Birrabeen. We'll put the name in the bottom here, so don't worry. And we're the only ones here. So that's pretty cool. Anyway. Check this out. Alright, here we are back again. Time is roughly 6:30, I believe. Kira doesn't expect me to record anyway when I get to these sort of places. We are currently at Central Station. It is, say, halfway between the bottom third of the island, and it's probably the best spot to get on when you come back down from the top to get onto the barge, so you don't rush it in the morning, or in the morning to from the top of the island, because it can take over an hour to get down to this part. So, and it's not a bad spot to get to this stage. It's nice and quiet in the nights. So let me do that so I don't get the sunlight in the camera. Other than that, yeah, it's a lovely spot. Noise curfew at 9 o'clock. So it all quietens down. Definitely a little bit louder than Waddy.
See.
But yeah, other than that, it's pretty cool. Mm. So right now we are getting up to go to Lake Mackenzie. Mm-hmm. Going to Kira's favourite spots was going to be.
Mm.
So yeah, come if you're heading down or heading up from on Fraser Run, come check out Central Station. It's not bad. It's another dingo proof area. So you have no worries about dingoes coming in, but they do say still lock your stuff up because other animals like lizards and birds.
Snakes.
So yeah, come check out Central Station. All right, here we are back again. We have made it to Lake Mackenzie. We're just walking down there now. Yeah. So, yeah, he is hoping it's going to be a little bit better than getting up late.
Yeah. It's already, like, 120 meters away.
Yeah. Well, at the moment there's only three cars here, and there's only one couple that we've seen so far. So it's definitely not nowhere near as busy as what it will be in about
hour or two.
Yeah. So anyway, come check this out.
Go, pussy!
Alright, so that was Lake Mackenzie, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed that. It was pretty cool.
Cold.
Well, it wasn't too bad. I reckon that was warmer than Eli, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And it's pretty cool because it drops. You'll see it in the drone footage and stuff like that. You'll see it where it comes off to the black area, and that's where it drops off to about 9 meters plus. So it's pretty hectic. But anyway, we don't know what we're going to do now because we got up early to do this. We may go and see another lake. May go do something else. We don't know. So, yeah.
Anyway, I loved it.
It was awesome. Anyway, we'll kick back soon. We'll figure out what we're going to do now. All right, back again. So we've just driven back to Central Station. We're not at the campsite itself at the moment. We're at Central Station, actually. We'll explain when we get back up to the top there. But we have come down to the local creek. Can't remember the name of it. Probably put it down the bottom here. So you guys can work it out how to pronounce it. Apologies. But, man, let me tell you, Kira.
It's crystal clear water.
Kira had to do a double take.
I thought it was just sand.
Yeah. So it's crystal clear. Come check it out when you swing by here, if you're coming past Central Station. It's pretty cool. Give you a sneaky history to the European history. A sneaky look into the past of the European settlement here, because it used to be a logging establishment here. So yeah, come check out Central Station.
So we were walking along the walk like Tom is right now, and we found these, and I was like, wow, these are really cool. And like, it's got carvings of like frogs and everything in it and everything, and I was like, that's amazing. Got closer, and on the top of all these they have braille writing. Like, that's amazing. There's like a little bat there. So amazing, love it.
Hey,
what's the matter?
We bent our this thing.
Oh, God.
I can't remember what it's called. It's the trailer light plug. We bent it to the point where it was up here. So we hit something. I don't know what, but we hit something.
I can't remember either.
Yeah. But it should be an easy fix as long as none of the electrics are kaput. I'll be shocked if they are, but as long as none of the electrics are gone, we're good. I just had to bend this back. So yeah.